Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Coldborough Park Farm, where today we have little Deutz out cultivating. And I do have some sort of GPS module on, deal with it. You're going to have to deal with me being a bit unrealistic in using a GPS with this thing. Because this is the only way I'm not going to run over a ton of stuff and cause issues with the cultivator script, basically. So, I actually want to... I'm thinking about selling something, but I don't know. I'm thinking about selling something because I want to buy something, I should say. It's not just I want rid of this now. I'm bored of it. So actually, yeah, I'm gonna sell a couple of things. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna turn off the Deutz here and leave it kind of roll back. I'm gonna roll over here though, because I'm gonna pick up the case over here. Now, the case is all well and good, but it's a bit too powerful for a yard tractor, isn't it? I mean, I'm only going to be using this for loader work. And quite frankly, I could get something less powerful, maybe a bit older than this rather beautiful case, JXU85. I mean, return and get the 115 at some point if I decide I want something that's a bit more powerful for loader work. But for right now, it's just not what I need. And I'm actually going to pick something up on the way over to the shop, because I want to get rid of that as well. Need to make some changes. I also need to sort out the Seedmaster. Probably... I'm going to leave it fill up completely and just leave it for a while. It's almost 4 months. So we're picking up one of these. So the question is, am I picking up the sprayer or the spreader? Because just ignore the fact that the So I'm picking up the sprayer. That's going to be sold off. So is the case, so is the front loader arm, so is the thing. This subsoiler is staying because that's going to be creating tram lines. That's how I make the tram lines. If you watch Nustin, you might have been wondering, how the hell did you get such good tram lines, Dave? Well, the trick is I recorded a course in Courseplay while I was spraying, and just kind of set that as my tram line course. The trick is go around the outside first, then use that as kind of a base. Then go up and down, so you get the nice proper tram line effect going on. Ideally you'll be using GPS with that as well, and I know I'm talking out of character, but deal with it, I'm giving genuine advice for once. Ideally you'll be going up and down with GPS, so you get nice straight lines, so you get the really nice like circle of the field, and then the straight line and the little curve and the straight line coming back. And that's how I did it on Nustin, that's how I'll be doing it here as well. It's relatively basic, I know, but it's the best way of doing it. There's no like ideal way, there's no perfect way. I'm gonna turn on the lights as well as the beacons, which are spazzing out the screen as usual. One thing I really do like about the case is that the indicator lights actually work, which doesn't seem to be the case in most tractors I've used. So I do feel a bit guilty getting rid of this, but I've got something a bit special coming. In fact, it's already here, I just need to drop it over to the shop. They've opened a bit later than usual tonight just to accommodate this happening. So they know I'm on my way. They know what I'm bringing, they know what I'm buying, so it's all ready to go. I just need to get it over, get this stuff over there, and basically let them know I'm there, so they can bring out the stuff that I am buying. There are a couple of items that I've left there. They're taking care of it for a while. They'll keep it all nice and secure for me. So we're almost there now. Just gonna ignore the speed limit for the rest of this and just get over there as quickly as possible. I will have to go significantly slower in my new vehicle. Which is going to remain a mystery until such a time as I buy it. So I will have to be going slower in my new vehicle. It's out of character, it's not up to my usual standard. But when you see what vehicle it is, you can possibly, if not probably, understand why on earth I'm going for it. It's something that I've said I've wanted for a long time. In FS15, and I was graciously granted access to the to a private mod of it yesterday during the stream. So if you really, really want what I'm about to pick up really badly, you can look through yesterday's stream, which I'll put up at some point. What number the stream was. I'm not gonna check. I think it was like off-camera stream number 13 or something to that effect. So we're selling this and this and this and this. That's nice and empty. Let's go over here. We are buying in sprayers. We are getting the Monsoon Triton 500 because it's actually smaller than these big dudes, and fits the farm a bit better. I could go for the Triton 200, but that's a bit too small. And in, bizarrely enough, telehandlers normally, we have a bale spike, and I've just realized there may be a problem. I may need to get a cheaty mod at some point. And also, and finally, I guess, in front loaders, we see what I want. The Ford 5000 that I can only just afford. Good Lord, that was perfect. Yeah, that was pretty much perfect for the amount of money I had. So you'll see the max speed is 55. I tried to fix that. I ended up getting it up to 147. As a max speed, so I'm gonna manually be keeping this thing at most around the mid 30s in terms of speed. So let's pick up the bale spike, get around the front of the Triton 500, and we'll be picking that up too. The joy of this thing is it's got a nice open back, so I can look down at the 3-point and see exactly where on earth I'm going. Like so, and we'll pick that up. All nicely attached. Raise that up. Hopefully, it's not too heavy. Beacon on. Unfortunately, it does have a beacon. It is on. I promise. Again, I also promise the indicators are working. And let's head off. So there are a few issues with this. The grip coefficients are a bit odd. It's obviously just made to 2013 standards and converted fairly hastily into 2015. But I don't mind. What else is that? It is not quite right. Obviously the front attacher is only properly working with telehandler tools for whatever reason. That could cause issues, and I'm going to have to edit something else to fix that. Well, to fix the issue that I'm going to have with seeds so that I can actually use them. The IC, you can see it's there, doesn't work. And yeah, the max speed is 55. So it's not, maybe not the best conversion ever. but it is definitely a working one, and that's kind of what I wanted. So this is going to be our yard tractor from now on. This is going to be what's essentially shunting things around the yard, as well as loading up the bale trailer. Because this thing has pretty good luck, if memory serves. I'll test it once we're in the yard. Although judging by the amount of having to turn, it maybe isn't the best luck ever. The added bonus of this is basically we can use this on the classics farm. I mean, this is I think it's very late 60s the Forces came out. 5000, this is a 5000, it just happens to be 5000 with a front loader, which I know certain people don't like, but they'll have to deal with. I don't know why I'm using the indicators. I was going to say there's no indication the indicator's on. No, I lied. There's actually an indication of the indicators, so I'm going to just pull in here real quick and show you guys. So, if you look at the... if you look at the left of the cab, you'll see a little stick and a flashing light. That's right indicator. That's left indicator, and I'm guessing if I put the hazards on the middle... Oh, they both light up. Awesome! And obviously the entire cab lights up once you turn on the lights. Which is a nice little bonus. Now, I am having to manually keep the speed down, because if I go too quickly, the tractor will start to drift and start trying to flip. What I'm going to do is I'm actually going to go out of the cab just to show this off a bit better. It's the Ford 5000 with a front loader. Yes, the lights aren't the greatest. It's a fairly hasty convert from 2013. It's not the best piece of equipment ever, but it is most definitely a beautiful piece of equipment. And that's all I really want. So let's put the Triton 500 in where the... I think it was the Technoma was the one I had. Whatever the sprayer had, where that was. It's going to fit in nice and neatly. Oh no, this thing has quite good luck, never mind. And I can't see where I'm going. You'll have to deal with me scraping the Triton along the ground. I literally can't see otherwise. And that's that in. Let's disconnect it. And we'll just pull the Ford forwards and test the steering lock at a full 450 degrees to the left. It's not the best ever. It's definitely not the best ever, but it's definitely nice and tight. I mean, we are making a nice, relatively tight circle for the age of the tractor. And that's pretty much what I want. So let's pull this in over here. And just park it up across from the windrower, I guess. Those seed pallets are essentially just for show at this stage. We don't need them. I'm going to keep them just in case there's an issue somewhere. And I do, you know, in case there's an issue, I need to buy seeds and use the pallets. So that's that. Parked up. Forgot to turn off the lights. So we got a lovely little Ford 5000 in there. We'll probably be getting more Forces as time goes on to bulk up the classics area, the classics section of the farm. As for right now, we are in field 5 over here, which is also known as the hop yard. For some reason I thought it was a little meadow. Nope, it's the hop yard. And yeah, I decided to do some work with the little Deutz, essentially for the reason that I was getting bored of driving the Massey. I still have a couple of fields to go. As you can see, field 6 there, still needs to be worked on. I have completely knocked myself over here, I think. Oh, never mind. Field 6 needs work, but that's something I'm willing to deal with. It's an issue I'm willing to have. For whatever reason, the camera locks off to the left like that a lot. Let's lock GPS in. Drop that. And away we go. So yeah, I basically got bored of driving the Massey. In between now and tomorrow, when you see the stream, I'll probably do some off-camera stuff. Some legit off-camera stuff between now and the stream. Just because this is taking an age, it's going to take an age, and I don't want you guys to have to sit through it all. I'm not that evil. I may be insane, but I'm not insane enough to think that you guys will want to see all of this. On the bright side, this thing has such a ridiculously tight turning circle that I can do that. I mean, I'm still taking it kind of easy on the whole give myself a headland thing. That's quite a headland for this vehicle. But it's more than enough for me to turn around, which is kind of the point of a headland. So, no complaints there. I do apologise for not having a stream on Monday. I literally woke up and the stream would have been nearly over. I woke up and it was like 4:30 before I got out of bed even. Yesterday I was quite pleased, so today as I'm recording this, quite pleased that my whole I've actually got out of bed at a human time thing that I did. That was pleasing to me. And hopefully today, as in today when you're seeing the video, I'll have gotten out of bed at an also reasonable time, because I am tired as hell and it's only 9:30. Which is good news for me. I'm going to try and record the Project L video for tomorrow after this. Hopefully I can find the energy to do it. The car that I've planned is, for anybody interested, it is, looking at my little reference sheet, Ford Focus, I think it's RS. I wrote up a little reference sheet without actually looking at the car list in the game. I think it's the RS model of Focus. I know there is like a Focus in there. That's tomorrow's car. The stream on Friday is going to be, and you may have noticed I've given the week's themes instead of just randomly picking very difficult cars. You may not have noticed even, because last week was Formula Car Week. Well, this week we're going to kind of continue on from that. I mean, we've done modern Formula Cars this last week, and this week we're going to go back in time a bit. And just thinking about it, do I want to shoehorn that car into this week? Or next week? I'll shoehorn it into this week. I just changed my plans for this week. I was originally going to do just the Lotus Formula 1 cars, but I remember there's actually a Lotus Formula Ford. And for reasons of I've literally just decided this, also fits more into the classic formula cars category than anything else. That is going to be starting off the stream this week. We'll start off with the Formula Ford, because I believe that's the oldest of the Lotuses, and then we'll basically go through the Formula 1 cars in chronological order. So we'll be doing the Lotus 49 I think is the 49C, the one what has the wing, so the 49 will technically get 2 laps. Then we'll move on to 72, the 78, and the 98T. And to be quite honest, the 98T is the one that I'm looking forward to the most. The 72 and 78 are relatively easy to drive. The 49s drive fairly similarly. The wing car obviously has downforce. I was going to say more downforce. It has downforce. So yeah, I'm looking forward to that one as well. The 49s, they're not easy cars to drive. They've got 1960s style Formula 1 tires, so they've got tires that could last two full races, and those races were not short. I also need to take down times from the IndyCar and the Caterham I did last week, so that's kind of my plan for the rest of the night, is plan stuff out and get things arranged. Because I haven't updated the Project Hell Google Doc in a while. It's something that I should have been doing pretty much daily. Or whenever I get a lap done. Not during streams, because that would just break up the stream unnecessarily. And you've noticed that you might have noticed that I stopped doing that, because I do know that a lot of people might not necessarily like motor racing, but the Project Hell is not motor racing. Project Hell is me setting myself a challenge to drive all these silly cars, all of them. And by the way, next week's video, I'm returning to a car that I deemed impossible. So next week is going to be the return of the R8 VA10 Plus. The reason for that being, I'm giving myself a damn week to get a lap done. That's going to be a post-commentary lap. Because I'm literally just going to start up, probably even just start up OBS or something, and start trying to do laps. And once I get a successful lap, I'll just use scraps like usual. Once I get a successful lap, I'll bring it into my video editor and commentate it. Because I don't want you guys hearing my frustration. And I will take note of how many attempts it took to get a lap together, because that bug that I found is game-breaking. The fact that the wheel comes up through the chassis of the car is a genuine issue. Anyway, talking about farming, because that's what I should be doing in this video, not motor racing, which I do love, but it's not very fitting for this video. Not a whole lot been going on the farm. For those of you with eagle eyes, you may have noticed up here, the 1 has miraculously turned into a 5. I have extended the amount of time I have between soil mud stages, probably temporarily, potentially permanently. All I need to do is find the shortcut that allows me to insta-skip to the next stage in soil mud, and that's a permanent change. As for work being done, I have, at this point, most of the fields cultivated. I just need to do 6 and 7, I believe. I'll be running through them all again. Just as a kind of insurance for myself. Once they're cultivated, well, once they're disced to this state, they will all need to be cultivated again, which is why I decided to do off-camera work. I want to get them cultivated under as quickly as possible and not limit myself to videos and streams. So I won't have the camera turned on at all times. Despite what I said, I won't have the camera on at all times, just because, do you guys really want to see like 12 or 13 hours of me cultivating? Because that's what it's going to take, is 12 or 13 hours of me cultivating. I've screwed up the GPS now. Nope, over a bit. That looks about right. So yeah, there is going to be proper off-camera work, just because I don't want you guys to get burnt out. I don't want to get burnt out either, and the fact that I'm having to commentate, yeah, the fact that I would otherwise have to try and commentate over multiple hours of the same thing, It's not fun for you guys. It's not fun for me. It's not fun for anybody involved. I'm just gonna start this line here. Screw it. Drop that in, and away we go. Super culty away. So I'm gonna push it again because this is gonna be a thing for a while, as I'm gonna be pushing this stuff towards the end of videos. So for those of you who are interested, who've hopefully watched the entire video, I am on all worthwhile social media. Tumblr is not a worthwhile social media, so don't expect to see a rainbow day of Tumblr anytime soon. Although I may do that as a kind of vlog, I don't know. I know that everybody I watch who's been on Tumblr has closed it because of the Tumblr. So there's a Facebook page, facebook.com/rainbowdayofgaming. There is also a Steam group. It is steamcommunity.com/groups/rainbowdayofgaming, or you can just search Rainbow Dave Gaming on Steam. It should come up fairly quickly. I think RDYT might search correctly, because that's the four-letter code I've set for the group. Why is this two different passes? That's mildly concerning. If you search RDYT, you might just find it. I wouldn't put a bet on that, but it's a possibility. And if you want to follow me on Twitter, where I do occasionally actually tweet random junk, it is @rainbow_Dave. Because I've realized it's a lot easier to just say the at, to give you my at sign, than the actual Twitter URL, because it's kind of assumed that it's twitter.com/@URL. The reason it's not @RainbowDave is because somebody already took it before me. That's fine. Yeah, I'm not the only person who identifies as a Dave and also identifies as Rainbow. I also, for those of you who are Tumblr who do enjoy being special little snowflakes, sexually identify as a Sikorsky SH-62 attack helicopter. Because I'm that special little snowflake who just has to be different. In all seriousness, please stop doing that, Tumblr. That just strikes me as transphobic, the special little snowflake-itis that Tumblr has. And then they complain about everybody else being transphobic because, cis white male. All that kind of nonsense. So are you! You just decided you're a dog for some reason. Check your genetics. And before you say check your privilege, I did last night, I'm not privileged. I found a Facebook quiz thing and I was like, let's answer honestly and check what my privilege actually is. The answers came back, no, you're not privileged. So, screw you, Tumblr. I don't know why I'm attacking Tumblr today. Just in one of those moods. So yeah, the Deutz is going to work well. The 5000 is going to do its damn job. I'll make sure of that. So we've now spent 41,500 on classic tractors alone. That's ignoring the classic equipment that we bought. That's quite a lot of money, and I'm now going to have to cart all of the grain, which is the next job after the cultivation. That's all going to have to go by hand. I say by hand, by tractor. I was going to rent a truck, but I can't afford that now because I've decided to drop €41,000 on old tractors. But they're nice old tractors, and that's the important thing. Plus, I think we should get enough from the grain that it shouldn't matter all that much. Also, I'm not going to do the whole taking like 30% of harvesting come away, no. I don't know, I think the better thing to do is buy tractors that are intentionally inefficient, and that'll cost money. It's kind of why I've gone for the classic tractor thing, is because I know for damn sure they're inefficient. I also need to fiddle the classic seeder, because it currently does not accept the seeds that I'm making. I need to fix that. Why is that offset so much? Huh. But yeah, I need to fix that. That's going to be like a 30 second job at most. Because I know exactly what I need to put it into where. What I'll do is I will actually record a quick tutorial on how to add seeds how to make a seeder compatible with seeds too and the seed master, because I do know a few of you guys who do watch our budding map editors and map fiddlers. Which reminds me, I actually need to check my Steam messages because I've got a few that I need to deal with. So I might not record a project outside after all. When I'm done with this. I don't know why I'm telling you this. This is completely irrelevant information for you guys. It's only relevant information if I'm saying this live, and this isn't live. This is just me giving a damned train of thought about something that I'm going to do yesterday. If it's me saying, oh yeah, I'll probably hop on Steam 5 minutes in a stream, it's like, oh, okay, so, yeah, that's fine. Me saying, oh, I'm going to hop on Discord in 5 minutes after, you know, in a stream or in the Steam group chat, which, by the way, I do lurk in. I'm in that most of the time, so if you don't want to chat in YouTube chat or whatever, or you don't want to add me on Steam for whatever reason, because, you know, if you're in the group, you'll know that I'm the admin. You can... Also, that's how you know it's the... like legit group, is I'm the admin of the Steam group, just in case there's a faker group out there somewhere for some reason. I don't know why there would be, but yeah. And Facebook, it's the only Rainbow Dev Gaming page. It's got all the stuff. It's got all the logos and stuff that I use, so it's legit. In any case, we're just about out of time. I've actually overrun slightly over what I wanted, which is kind of fine. So, I'm going to leave you saying, do like the Facebook page, do join the Steam group, and do follow me on Twitter. Also, do comment, like, and subscribe. I will be very pleased with any and all of those actions. Also, you may have noticed that the mystery bells have disappeared. I deleted them. Something I didn't actually reference. Yeah, I got rid of the bales, all of them. I just flat out deleted them, didn't give myself money for them, because why the hell should I? They're bales I could be bothered moving, I don't deserve to profit from that. So, yeah. I will see you next time. Tomorrow's stream is Coldborough Park Farm, just for those of you who are watching Notification Squad or whatever, because I do know that's a thing. That's a thing on YouTube for some bizarre reason, that people like announcing that they signed up for notifications. And if you have, do say it in the comments. I mean, I'm not going to complain about somebody saying notifications, but I'll be actually quite shocked. But yeah, tomorrow's video is Project Hell Lap of the Ford Focus RS. Just because it's a relatively easy car to drive. The stream tomorrow is called Park Farm, and that is at the usual time. I got confused there. I was looking at tomorrow for me, not tomorrow for you. So yeah, you get to see the continuation of this cultivating nonsense. Until then, stay safe, and please don't ever try doing this. Sorry, I've got a bit of gas. I do apologize. Stay safe, and goodbye.